Hello YouTube people, today I will show you Casio A168 and I will do some modifications with this watch. I'm gonna put in negative LCD screen, which I have already prepared from another watch, same module. We'll see how it looks like. Also gonna put it on F91W rubber strap. We'll see if it fits and how it looks like. But first I would like to compare this 168 to its brother 159, and for 159 is closer to F91W because it has the same module of F91W, so it has the same backlight, that just little LED shining in the corner. And this one, 168, has big and strong backlight. Its full screen is just shining very strong, but I don't know, maybe because of that the watch itself is a lot thicker than 159. The difference is, I have written down, A159 by my measurements is 8.4 millimeters in thickness, and this 168 is 9.7 millimeters in thickness, 9.7. So maybe numbers don't look that different, maybe it doesn't look that different on camera, but what can I tell you that in person they are very different. The thickness is very noticeable on 168, and I don't like that. I don't like that. And speaking about that backlight, F91W or 159 has perfect backlight. It doesn't look cool with just little LED in the corner, but in the middle of the night, that's exactly what I need. I don't want to be blinded by the bright backlight. F91W just gets the job done for me and it doesn't blind me. While A168 has strong backlight, but checking out the time at 4 a.m. in the morning, it's the same as checking time on the phone. It's just too bright, it blinds me. So that's my take on this backlight. Anyway, this watch looks kinda dressy, still kinda nice watch. But for me, the problem with this watch is the same as with 159. That is just shiny plastic, it's very easy to scratch. Yeah, cheap watch, but it's very scratchable, it's not durable whatsoever. Speaking in terms of visual durability. Okay, let's get to the point and let's start some modifications. So let's put in the negative LCD screen, let's see how it looks like. But before that, take a better look with positive LCD screen. And the next shot I will show you will be with negative LCD. I won't show you the video how I switch, how I mod. You saw that already on my channel. I'll just switch the shot instantly to the one with negative LCD screen. And by the magic of editing, the next shot is negative LCD screen. So I don't know. Tell me which you prefer better. What can I tell you is that it's rather difficult to read the time. Not as bad as on Casio A1000 with negative LCD screen. Not that bad, but still, as you can see in these shots. Yeah, it's a little bit difficult. It looks, maybe it looks a little bit cooler than positive, but I don't know. I wouldn't do it for myself. I would actually keep the positive LCD screen. So, and the silver bracelet. Positive LCD screen looks a little bit better in my personal opinion. So you know what, let's try, let's put it on Casio F91W strap and let's see, maybe we will find the balance, you know, negative LCD screen and black rubber strap. Well, not gonna lie, it was a snug fit, it took some time, but I did it. Here is the end result. Looks nice. I like this the best. I like it better than the original. Negative LCD, black F91W strap. This is not the first Casio, shiny Casio, that looks better on F91W rubber strap, in my opinion. Also, how is the backlight with negative LCD screen? It looks super cool. It looks really cool. Very nice, very nice. Not bad, not bad. Okay, so towards the end, what are my conclusions? Where I gonna place this watch on my tier list, thomaswatchreviews.com? Where is it gonna go? Well, it's not a bad watch. So that's where it goes. It's not a bad watch. Me personally, I prefer 159 because it's slimmer. It's more elegant because of that. But if you really need that strong backlight, well, then this is your option. And the extra thickness is a compromise, unless you really like that extra thickness. Maybe. Okay. That's the end result. Okay, thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye.